Tina's coming home tomorrow. I'm a little worried I won't know how to act around her.
Just treat her the way you normally would.
Honey.
What do you think? I couldn't wait. I wanted to surprise you.
All our number three, you and number six, are having dinner tonight at Michelli's, and WWEN is picking up the tab.
Her name's Emily. She's smart, she's creative, she's funny, and I can't believe she likes me.
You slept with her?
Why are you getting so agitated? It's not like I'm gonna marry her.
Wait a minute.
Oh.
David, this is my fiancé, Owen.
The lawyer.
The guy who lives in the lounge.
Maybe I shouldn't have kissed that doctor at work.
Do you have feelings for this guy?
I'm in love with Owen.
Will you marry me? Again?
Oh, yeah.
Barry Manilow's gonna sing at my wedding.
Louis Chama Pavarotti's gonna sing at mine. He's a famous tenor from Italy.
Are you gonna get married in Italy, Sid?
No, I'm gonna get married at the Sutter Mansion.
What's the Sutter Mansion?
A fancy club, members only.
I'm gonna get married at Fenway Park. I'm gonna marry Kaya Stremski, and Barry Manilow's gonna sing.
No one's gonna marry you. You look like a strawberry tart. Got any tea for a weary traveler?
English breakfast. It's kind of strong.
Nothing like a little girl talk on a Saturday afternoon. Huh, girls?
What was your wedding like, Mom? Did you have a big band and lots of dancing?
Listen, girls. Weddings are what you make them. It doesn't matter where it happens or who sings or even where you go on your honeymoon. It matters who you marry.
My husband's gonna be smart and funny and handsome.
And the luckiest man in the world. Pinkies up, sweeties. Always sip, never gulp. Oh, and Sid, next time you want to use my good teapot, ask first.
Night cruises under a tropical star-swept skies. You and your lovemate will embark on a honeymoon journey of unlimited possibilities and infinite pleasures. And don't forget our popular all-you-can-eat poo-poo platter.
Oh, don't talk to me about poo-poo platters.
I'm trying to cheer you up.
I don't know what hurts more, my head or my throat.
Whoa, let me take your temperature.
I really thought I'd feel better today. Maybe you should...
Call in sick for you? I can do that. See, when I was sick, my mother would pull the blinds and do a puppet show.
I want to feel better.
I'm telling you, those puppet shows were really something. She'd do all the great operas. Tosca was my favorite. Tosca was a singer who, after she stabs this lecherous creep who's been torturing her boyfriend, she flings herself off a parapet.
Huh.
My mother's just a phone call away.
No, that's all right. I have so much to do. I have to track down our honeymoon journey of unlimited possibilities. Although I did have my heart set on Santa Felipe.
Well. Too bad that pesky hurricane got there first and wiped out that pristine, sandy white beach. More important thing is to get you better.
Who's the doctor around here anyway?
I'll be back after my lunch with Willie Picks.
You really think he's gonna show up?
I hope so. Can't wait to see the look on his face after I hand him a royalty check for a song he wrote 40 years ago.
You're like that clearinghouse sweepstakes guy.
And I'm gonna bring you home the second best thing to cure your illness, music. Willie Picks CD.
No, it was the first thing. Oh, yeah. Top of the show.
pretty song.
We found the sheet music in the piano bench. Maybe Hannah could play that at the wedding.
Oh, I don't think that's the right note. Is that supposed to be an A, sweetie?
No, it's a D.
Flashback to my battle axe piano teacher, Miss Bryant. She used to smack my fingers with a fly swatter.
Ow. You know, this might actually look okay.
I'm telling you, this is the first bridesmaid dress I'm not turning into a costume at Halloween. I hear the B&B's pretty fab, too.
It's coming along, slow and steady. That's not really the problem, though.
Problem?
No, no, it's just I'm probably overreacting.
Hello, ladies. How's it going in here?
Hey.
Those look fantastic.
Only the muslin samples.
They're fantastic muslin samples. A princess rose for the princess.
Thank you.
I could see how that could be a problem.
He's decided that we need to spend more time on us.
Us?
He thinks we're missing romance.
Well, everybody needs a little romance in their life.
Joni, this is the 17th princess rose in 3 days. The novelty wears off.
It might.
I gotta run out to the store. Do you want to look over the dance schedule? And the tango looks pretty good to me, but maybe the mambo? Oh. Oof. What happened to him?
Oh, Pretty Boy got in a fight with another cat.
I guess the other cat found out his name was Pretty Boy. So I've been thinking of hiring a babysitter for Nick. I've already talked to a couple people. I mean, there's so much going on right now with the B&B, the wedding.
What's Tina say?
I don't know. I thought it could be a surprise.
Hey, don't you think you ought to run it by her first?
Yeah, well, okay, thanks.
Sorry I'm late, Dr. Hansen.
No problem, Heather. I'm just finishing up Pretty Boy here.
Oh, that sounds like a good idea. You know how you've always told me I should be more spontaneous?
More spontaneous? Doesn't ring a bell.
Ring a bell? That's funny. I mean, it will be when you see it. Her. You see, I've got this friend, and he needs to sell it. Her. Really quickly. And so I bought her for us.
You bought us a present?
Want to see?
Sure.
Ta-da! They call her Daisy. Look.
You bought us an ice cream truck?
A mobile pet grooming service. An offshoot of the clinic, if you will. I can run it, maybe increase business for you.
Well, that's very sweet of you, Heather, I think. Is there a way to turn off the music?
I think that it's an amazing idea.
It's genius. There have been all these studies that show that people who like pets also like music. Thus, when people with pets hear music, they want to make their pets happy. So they buy more doggy treats.
Did you see this on the Pet Psychic Show?
No, I just made it up, but I think it's pretty convincing, don't you? Here we go.
Next selection.
Who let the dog sound?
I'll take three. What the hell? I'll take the whole tray. Okay. Maybe I do need to do something else with this place. You know, like those concerts in the quad. We're so close to campus, we could do something like that on a smaller level. Rockin' Friday nights at the Barkery.
Brilliant. Are you going to go to the Rebecca Lynn Howard concert in the Quad tomorrow?
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't miss it. How about you?
Oh, yeah. Emily loves her. Yeah, she's already freaking out about what she's going to wear.
To an outdoor concert? Taffeta, gold lame bustier.
This whole clothes thing is starting to drive me nuts. I mean, all she does is talk about how much she hates her clothes and her shoes. She takes Polaroids of her shoes, tapes them to the shoe boxes. What is that?
Trouble in paradise.
Absolutely not. It's nothing. It's just, she does this thing when we kiss. She burps.
What?
She burps, you know, like. She does it all the time. It's this weird thing. She's been to a gastroenterologist.
That's totally freaky.
You get used to it after a while.
I guess you'd have to.
Well, actually, no, I guess that's about all the questions I have.
Home. Oh, sorry.
It's okay. You want to go to a movie later?
I'm a little tired.
Let's just go out. Short drive.
Okay. If your dad or Joni can watch Nick.
No problem. Honey, it's not that I don't love being with Nick or Pete.
I know. Better get back to your phone call.
Sorry about that. So I guess I'll see you in a couple of hours, huh?
How you feeling?
Hey, you're back early.
You're right. Willie didn't show. I'm not even sure if he's in town. So, how's that honeymoon search going?
Everything good's already booked and the rest is too touristy. It's hopeless.
Yeah, who needs a honeymoon anyway? You sound worse.
Grab me that flashlight. Ah, this isn't good. That looks like strep. You want to see?
No. I'll pass.
If I call in a prescription...
I'll go pick it up, but don't you think I should take you to a doctor?
Owen.
All right. I have some stuff here guaranteed to lift those sagging spirits. There you go. Did you know that Mickey Mantle and Elvis Presley have been cryogenically frozen and sent on a secret spaceship to colonize Mars? Really, read it. I'll try not to make you laugh. All right, pat his tummy. Oh, see, I thought you could pretend that was Dr. Augustine and throw him across the room. Ah, remember these?
Oh, yeah, Wheelie.
The Star Wars replica lightsaber. Actually, I'm keeping that one. And a CD from the talented yet elusive Billy Picks. I'm telling you, this guy rocks. I know it's not traditional, but you gotta hear this. Oh man, this stuff's perfect for the wedding. What do you think? It's like a sweet refrain. Real true love. It's like a burning flame. My love for you.
I think of what Fiona Apple was singing about, and that last song is a perfect way to open up this hour of love chat. Today's topic, how well do you know the person you're dating?
Love these boots.
Okay, how well do you really know a person? For example, I know this guy. He runs a video store. He met this girl, things are going great, but it turns out, get this, when they kiss, she burps.
Gross.
Can you believe it? You're on the air.
That's disgusting. Why does he keep going out with her?
Well, because he likes her, duh. You're on the air.
What's wrong with the guy? There's gotta be something wrong with him. Maybe it's his breath.
Oh, no, he's a great guy. I mean, he's a friend of mine.
And he knows you're talking about his belching girlfriend on the air? Some friend.
Mobile Peppermint, we come to you! Mobile Peppermint, we come to you!
Hi there, that's a cute little doggy. How about a nice flea dip and a trim?
That poor little Poochie.
This message is for Willie Picks. This is Owen Frank. Willie, I'm sorry we missed each other at lunch. Still hoping we could get together. Why don't you give me a call at the office, 555-0168, or at the apartment, 555-0136. Maybe we should get you to the hospital.
Hospital? Owen, I have a cold. It'll be fine. I just took more ibuprofen.
Would you quit being the doctor? I want somebody to look at you.
I started antibiotics, all right? If I'm not feeling better in the morning, you can do whatever you want. Owen?
Mm-hmm.
What is that?
Tosca. Entourage enemy.
Baron Scarpia.
How are you feeling, Sid?
I'm not talking to a sock.
Kiss me, or I kill your boyfriend.
Get away from me! I live for love, I live for art, I've never harmed a living soul!
Kiss me.
No!
Kiss me.
No! Kiss me. No! All right? Uno, due, tre. Once more.
You can see how that would make quite an impression on a 7-year-old. I worry about you.
Don't worry. Why don't you come make me some tea, and I promise I'll go back to bed.
Done.
Hey, Robbie, Nick. How are my boys?
Who are you?
I'm Lupe. I'm the new babysitter.
Hey, go easy on those zucchini slices.
Tina is such a fan of your recipe, she's gonna love it.
Does she know you're doing this?
No, she thinks we're going out, but I found a dinner for two at home might be more romantic.
All these surprises.
I just want her to be happy.
Of course you do. You know, sometimes...
There's a babysitter in the guest house. She says she's coming here 3 days a week.
Surprise!
Rob, don't forget the mushrooms. I'll be downstairs.
Her name is Lupe. 3 days a week, she could come in. More, less, you know, whatever you want.
You didn't ask me.
I thought you'd like the idea. It's a present.
But I didn't get to interview her. We didn't even talk about this. Robbie, you know, I know you're into this whole romance thing.
You're right. I should have asked you. I'm sorry.
We don't need a babysitter.
Sure we do. We can't keep bothering Dad or Joni. I don't want to become one of those parents who just can't do anything without their kids. You and me, we're important too.
Well, of course we are. But I can take care of Nick.
This is just going to make things easier. You know, and give us time to do things like take dance lessons. I just want to make sure everything's okay.
It is okay. But you have to trust me.
I do. Honey, this has nothing to do with what happened before.
Really? Then why did you hire a babysitter? To babysit me?
Circle all of the animals that start with the letter P. What does that look like?
A horse.
Does horse start with the letter P?
No.
Does it look like a little horse?
No, not really.
Well, if it did look like a little horse, what would you call it?
A pony. Oh, pee.
Oh, keep circling. I'll be right back. Hey, I've got a 30-minute block of golden oldies. You want to come in and say hi to Hannah?
What did you say on the radio today?
That Emily thing?
That was a secret. How could you just say something like that on the radio? Everybody heard.
Well, I didn't say your name.
You don't have to say my name. Everyone knows we're friends. They figured it out.
Well, I'm sorry. I needed filler.
Filler? I tell you something in confidence and you blab it all over the airwaves for filler?
Look, it's not that big of a deal.
It's a big deal to me. And it's a big deal to Emily. People have been burping at her all day. How could you do something like this?
Look, you didn't tell me not to.
I thought we were friends.
Well, we are.
I think we have a different definition of the word friend.
Hey.
Hey.
Any news on Willie?
He checked out of his hotel. Nobody's seen him. Maybe he's in space with Mickey Mantle and Elvis.
You find him.
You feeling okay, hon?
I'm just really tired.
Oh, my God. Sid, honey, can you hear me? Sid. Oh, my God. Patrice.
Dr. Hansen.
She's burning up. I didn't know what to do.
Henry, we need some help.
Bay Inn is empty.
Oh. Dr. Baylor. Dr. Hansen's here as a patient.
Where?
Bay Inn.
What happened?
She passed out in the kitchen. She's been sick for a couple days.
Fever? Sore throat? Any vomiting?
Yeah, fever, sore throat, no vomiting that I know of.
Why don't you wait outside? We'll let you know as soon as we have something.
Come on, Sid.
Open your eyes. Talk to me.
Taking antibiotics. She was sure that it was strep throat.
Too bad she didn't get a second opinion.
Well, I should have realized.
Yeah, it wasn't your fault, Owen. No one could have anticipated this.
Hello, everybody.
This is David Baylor, Sid's doctor.
Hey.
You're David Baylor.
Well, you two have met?
Sid mentioned his name. Evidently, one night, you guys were dealing with a mime and clown act together?
Yeah. Yeah, that was it. It was a crazy night.
Sure sounded like it.
So why don't we step outside? We're trying to determine if the infection causing her fever is bacterial or viral. I put her on a broad-spectrum antibiotic, but I'm leaning towards viral since her white blood cell count is only slightly elevated. She has mild bandemia, increased monocytes, and a slightly enlarged spleen, so I sent off a monospot and EBV titers.
You think it's mono?
It's my best guess, yeah.
Mommy, I beat this funny lady at checkers.
Oh, that's great, honey.
But what are you doing for her in the meantime?
Well, we're rehydrating her, but we can't do it too quickly or we'll dilute her electrolytes. So, unless you guys are fans of weak coffee and cafeteria food, there's really no reason for y'all to stick around.
I'm staying.
Well, you're not staying here alone. We'll take shifts.
I got the first shift.
I'll take Nick home and get him changed.
When the tests come back, I'll call anybody who's not here. I've got everybody's number, so.
Do you have mine, Uncle Owen?
I sure do. You'll be the first one I call, sweetie.
I know, pal. It's driving me crazy, too. Let's see what we can do about it.
What are you doing, Dr. Hansen?
Just trying to keep busy.
Is everything okay?
I hope so. Chester's feeling better. You can take him back to his owner. I was thinking about what you said. People down there don't have access to a vet. Thought I'd put some medical supplies on the truck.
A mobile vet clinic.
We can go out once a month, treat anybody who needs it pro bono.
That's a great idea. And to think I was clamoring for a grooming service. Oh, how could I have been so shallow?
All right, what's a five-letter word for ordered tones? Right, music. You okay?
Robbie?
Robbie hired a babysitter without consulting me first. And he wants to dance.
In the literal sense or more figuratively?
It's not that I'm not romantic, but I thought we'd be a family first and foremost. I mean, that's what happens when you have kids, right?
When I was growing up, my parents would take a trip to Bermuda once a year, just the two of them. We took family vacations too, but I said you have to keep the foundation strong and the house will never fall down. Married 38 years.
Wow. Keep the foundation strong and the house will never fall down. Okay. Thanks, Owen.
Yeah. We outsiders have to stick together, right? Will you excuse me? I have to make a quick phone call. Hey, Willie. It's Owen Frank again. I guess I should tell you what I'm calling about. That company you recorded down by the river for him owes you $38,000 in royalties. That's an awful lot of zeros on that check. So, okay, thanks. Checking in. I just want to say I'm grateful for Sid and our engagement, and I know I haven't thanked you in a while. But I have a request. This, whatever it is she has, seems to be getting worse, and I want to make sure you're not taking anything out on her that you should be handling with me.
Something specific, or just your behavior in general?
Something happened?
Oh, no. No change. I just like to come in here once in a while.
Well, something specific, or your behavior in general?
Quiet clears my head.
When I brought Sid in, you seemed awfully attentive.
It's my job.
Oh, yeah, I saw you doing your job. Maybe neither of us would be here if you knew what was wrong with her.
Okay. You know, she was delirious when you brought her in.
So you're saying it's my fault?
No, I'm just saying if I'd been the one looking after her.
But you weren't.
I am now. Is this about something else?
You tell me.
Knock it off. This chapel's for taking up matters with God. If you've got a problem with each other, take it outside.
Hey, I'm back from the hospital. Your dad's going over there in a couple hours if you want to go with him.
Great.
I'm sorry about yesterday. I know you were just trying to be nice, and I was...
Don't worry about it.
I think you're right. I want to work on us. So, I've decided... Maybe we should take a couple dance classes at home. What do you say?
A minute later. Let me go get something to eat.
Entropy is a considerable foe, but it doesn't have to beat us. I don't want our friendship to fall apart before we know it.
Me neither.
Mommy, look!
Oh, my God. Emily.
Wow. How'd she know you'd be here?
I told her I'd be stopping by. Well, that's the T-shirt I gave her. That's a collector's edition.
I guess she objects to collector's editions T-shirts.
Oh, she's breaking up with me.
Yeah, guess that's a safe observation.
Wait! Wait! I take my forgiveness back.
You can't do that!
I can and I do. I did. It's gone. Wait! Emily! Wait!
Point, Frank?
Oh, Willie Picks.
Now your secretary said I'd find you here.
Congratulations.
Wow, you're right. It's a lot of zeros. Sorry about your circumstances.
Well, my fiance is. They don't know what it is.
My mother always said music makes sick people well.
My mother says the same thing.
What you say?
Let's give it a shot, huh?
Why not? Well, hey, whoa.
What the hell you doing?
This is David Baylor, my fiance's doctor. This is Willie Picks, legendary blues musician.
Hi.
Hey, my mother always said music makes sick people well.
And she was right. Okay, but we don't allow live music in the ER, okay? Oh. She's gonna have to rely on the miracles of modern medicine for the time being.
Dr. Baylor, you better come have a look at Dr. Hansen.
Miracles of modern medicine, what'd you do to her? She's covered in hives.
I didn't know she'd be allergic to ciprofloxacin.
Well, you should have considered that possibility before you gave it to her.
I asked you if she was allergic to any medications.
She's having an allergic reaction.
I can see that. Now get the hell out of here. Both of you.
Give me 1 milligram of epinephrine and call respiratory therapy.
Stats.
Right away, Doctor.
Sunshine, head on up the river. I think you know what I mean.
Even the water's hot.
It's all in your head, sunshine. Now hold tight. You and me, we got places to go.
In all my dreams, still, you seem to leave me. When I awake, my so won't you come back and make me happy? I'll forgive, dear. I'll take all the blame.
You can DC the cooling measures, Patrice. She's afebrile. She's going to be fine.
Should I tell her fiancé?
No, I'll take care of that.
Welcome back, Dr. Hansen.
Mr. Frank.
How is she?
She's doing better. I stopped the antibiotics, put her on a short course of steroids to get rid of the allergic component. Her mono spot and her EBV titers came back positive.
So it's definitely mono?
Yes, it is definitely mono. She'll be sick for a while. She'll do fine at home.
Are you going to release her?
Later this afternoon, as long as her temp doesn't spike and she can show me she's able to swallow liquids. Unless you'd like me to hang on to her.
Oh, that's all right. May I see her?
You got 5 minutes. Then I'd like you to go home and give her some peace and quiet.
Okay.
Hey, may I have Dr. Hansen's chart? I'd like to check her latest set of vitals.
Dr. Hansen is no longer your patient. I'll be handling her case until she goes home. The minister told me about your little cat fight in the chapel. If I hear another raised voice, another stupid argument, I will bring Sydney home and I'll take care of her myself. Good day, gentlemen.
it up for Alphabet Soup. Yeah! All right. Now, what everybody has been waiting for, Rebecca Lynn Howard.
Thank you. This is Forgive.
That beat, that I wouldn't stick around if it ever came to this. Here
Mommy,
I am, so confused. How am I supposed to leave when I can't even move?
Okay, I was a total jerk. And I have a really big mouth, and that's a really, really big problem if you're a DJ and have your own talk show. If you just give me another chance...
I give it back.
Give what back?
My forgiveness. I know that you didn't mean to tell my Emily secret to the whole campus. I miss you.
I miss you, too. Oh, there's somebody else I need to apologize to. I haven't even met her.
I don't know if that's a good idea. I mean, I don't know if she wants to meet you.
Oh, right. Maybe you could talk to her. Just blame the whole thing on me.
Oh, I've already done that. I'll see you later.
Okay. Okay. See you later.
All right. Bye, Hannah.
Sick I was.
So, who you been kissing?
What are you talking about?
Didn't anyone tell you? You have mono. Snuck you some coffee ice cream. I figured you might be jonesing for the taste.
Oh, you read my mind.
There you go. Come on. You guys make pretty good tea.
They're not the only ones, you know?
Sid.
Hey.
Boy, am I glad you're okay. Hannah sends a big kiss.
You give Hannah a big kiss back.
Are you gonna eat all that?
I'm sorry.
You go first.
I really wanted to make things romantic. I guess I was trying too hard. Nice song.
Down, huh?
Practice with the threshold thing.
Hey, what's this?
Well, I figure we might regret having bagged a honeymoon, so I looked into renting houses. This is Kauai. 24-hour room service, massage, snorkeling equipment.
Owen, this is perfect.
You like it?
Are you kidding? I love it.
I'm glad you're better.
Oh, that makes two of us.
So is Dr. Baylor. I think he was as concerned about you as I was.
He's a great guy. Do me a favor. Put on that Willie Pick CD.
Your wish is my command.
You know, when I was in the hospital, I had this crazy fever dream, and Willie was in it.
My love for you is real.